only sister is calling. Where are the brothers? I told Sister Resi is in charge for the prayer. So that's why she is calling. Thank you, Father, for being with us for the day. And we are grateful to you for coming and being with us. I also take this opportunity to thank Mr. Tims and Georgian, who came over here to speak on behalf of the parents. I think they are excellent orators. A beautiful message along with what they felt from their heart they gave to us. We are grateful to you, and we are grateful to each of you parents sitting here. Your students or your children are not only your children, they are our children also. We appreciate them, we value them, along with the little corrections that we give. Thank you, parents, for those wonderful words and also the support that you are giving. A big thank you to all the parents sitting here. The various items on stage was fantastic. The children have performed very well. Thank you to them for each item that was prepared. I also take this opportunity to thank our dance master for preparing them day and night for this show. I know when the number is small, it is very difficult. But he has exceedingly done well. A good job done. Let us give him a big hand. A special word of thanks to our parish priest and assistant parish priest who are not here. They are just beginning with a retreat from today. That's why they are not able to be here. And also the sisters who have come from far, from Hospital St. Augustine's Hospital, and others who have come over here from different places. A big thank you to every one of you. Just coming to the message of the day, I would like to appreciate the children who put up various dances along with certain message. One beautiful message that I got from this morning's function is about looking after the parents and loving your parents. The mime that was put up here, followed by those PowerPoint presentation, it gave a beautiful message, not only to the children, to the middle-aged and those who are above 60. At every age, we got seniors. When we are at one stage, we fail to recognize the presence and the need to look after the elderly. If I am at the age of 20, I happen to criticize those who are in at the age of 8 or 9 or 10. When I am at 40, I criticize those who are in 20s and 30s. And when I am in 60s, I criticize all those who are up to 50s. It goes on. But the message given to us by that skit, by mime, is to respect people at every age, especially when they are down, when they are sick, when they are unhealthy. We forget to remember the years that they have spent to look after each one of us. As we go home from this boarding day function, let us tell to ourselves, every person born into this world and given to us friends, neighbors, and relatives, they are not a choice by us. They are given to us by God. And they are the people who have suffered for us and who will stay with us in the difficult times of day and night. And it is not a request that is given to us. It is something we need to do as human beings to look after our elders at whatever age they are. As we expect our children to respect us, we need to respect the elderly in our turn. What we do speaks more than what we say. And it is a message to each one of us to be good in our lives so that our children, our students, they not listen to us, but they see us and learn things from us. That is a reminder to each of us present here. A small story I would like to share with you today. It happened in San Francisco. In the evening of a day, a businessman was sitting by the beach side. He was very sad and sitting, looking down. He had suffered a huge loss. He was not able to go forward in life. His business was collapsing. He was finding it difficult. He was almost thinking of quitting the business and ending his life. As he was sitting there by the beach side, an elderly person came around. He looked at him and told him, "Friend, I see you down and out. You must be worried. You have some problem. Okay, I have a small gift for you." He took a check leaf from his pocket, signed in the check leaf, and gave it to the person who was sitting there. It was an amount of $500,000. And it was signed John D. Rockefeller. Many of us would know Rockefeller is one of the richest person that the world has ever seen. He signed that check and gave it to him and told him, "Next year, same time, you come back here. I am sure you would be able to return this money to me with interest." And he disappeared. Well, this man went and he saw this check for $500,000. He was very happy. He told to himself, "Okay, this is given to me. I am going to keep this as a memento. I am not going to use this." And he reworked in his business. He went back to the people who owed him money. He regrouped his group. He started working hard. And months passed by. The company which was at a loss, he started making profit. And he made payments to all the debtors. He was able to make a turn, a change. And he reversed the whole thing and became successful without using that check. And after a year, he came back to the same beach and sat there. And this old man, he came once again. He was about to get up and then present the check to that old man. Suddenly from the sidelines, a few white-clad people came and caught this man, this old man, and told this businessman, this executive who made a turn in his life, that this particular person, he escapes from the mental asylum, and he was about telling others that he is Rockefeller. Dear friends, he escaped from mental asylum and gave a check to this man who was downcast. He did not use that check. But whatever his condition was, the man was able to make a change in his life. You and I, are we able to realize the capacities, the hidden talents that are within us? Are we able to make our children understand and give them a positive idea that they can be successful in their life. They need not depend on others. We do not require gifts from others to succeed in life. God has given enough potential to each one of us. If we can realize that, if we can use it to the best of our ability, every one of us here, and I would say it, will be successful in the right way. And we shall pray to God that we become such agents who will propel others to find the hidden talents in them and navigate them towards success. Not with money, not with power, but just by standing by the side of them. And that's what is required today. Another small correction I would like to make to the skit that was played here. At the end, when we were finishing it, it was said that extracurricular activities are not so much important. Actually, when I went to the skit, I didn't notice that. What is required is curricular activities. There is some change in the world of today. It is not just your education by the percentage of marks that you gain going to take you forward. Today, extracurricular activities takes 50% of the success of a man or a woman. Curricular activities take the other 50%. Both should be there side by side. With one alone, you cannot go forward. So we need to tell ourselves, everything that we do in the school, whether it is curricular or extracurricular or co-curricular, everything that we do here is for our good and it will take us forward in life. And don't be mistaken, the best 10% of those who score in the school are not the most successful persons in the world. It is the those who are between 60 and 80. So, those parents who only tell the children to become a bookworm are not helping them to be successful in their life. We need to appreciate them for every work that they do. And it is important for today. In a special way, I pray for the 12th standard students and the 10th standard students who will be writing their board exams this year. It does matter. Do your best and leave the rest to God. God will help you if you help yourself. And we shall offer them into the hands of God that they will be able to do the maximum possible and become best students of Montfort in every aspect, including the curricular activities. My heartfelt thanks to all the teachers who are present here, right from KG to the 12th standard. You have groomed these children well. Got another few more days to go. We shall work together for the success of our children, that they may score well in their exam as they are doing well on stage also. Let me conclude my this short speech with the same words that Elvin had said here. She mentioned just one line from H.W. Longfellow, one of the greatest writer and poet whom I admire. Lives of great men all remind us we can make our lives sublime, and departing leave behind us footprints in the sands of time. Lives of great men all remind us we can make our lives sublime, and departing leave behind us footprints in the sands of time. Thank you. Have a good day. That, may I request the leaders of various houses in the boys' hostel to come forward. We have the overall trophy to be given. I request Brother Ignatius to come forward. Group
with
81 points. The love house comes first. The love house comes first with 81 points. Just 2 points down, Lighthouse with 79 points comes second. With 56 points, the Lifehouse comes third.
Jesus Christ.